The 2010 Winter Olympics on NBC 15 are now just a little more than 2 weeks away. Tonight, we continue our in-depth coverage of your local athletes who will be competing in this year's games.
Madison's Nicole Jorenstad is a member of the curling team, and while the UW alum will taste the Olympics for just the first time, she knows it'll be sweet. NBC 15's Nick Austin has her story.
It still seems like a dream come true that this team gets to go to the Olympics. We've been working so hard.
For Madison curler Nicole Jorenstad, her road to the Olympics, like most athletes, has been a long one.
My dad got me into the sport. He curled back in the 80s. He actually played against our coach, Wally. So they battled each other in national championships. And when I was about 15, he got me into the sport and gave up basketball and fast pitch and track and just decided to commit myself to curling. And then 10 years ago, I moved to Madison so I could be closer to curling, closer to a good coach that could position myself to be going to Winter Olympic Games.
Now that her U.S. team has earned a spot, she's got another challenge, fighting off that overwhelming feeling when the games begin.
There's definitely going to be nerves, but I think that the experience, you know, I've been to 6 world championships as a women athlete, and I've been to 2 junior women's championships, so I feel like that experience is going to help to know how to play best under that type of pressure.
She may be an Olympic rookie heading to this year's games, but Nicole has a veteran's goal. Gold or bust.
I'd have to say anything but a gold would be unsatisfying. You go there to play well, and it only comes around every 4 years, and you never know if you're going to go back. So we just want to make sure we put everything into it to make sure we're on the top of the podium.
Regardless of the outcome, Team USA skip or captain Debbie McCormick, a Rio resident, has an important message she's passed on to the team.
Don't sweat the small stuff and just really enjoy the experience. You know, it's really only 3 weeks. Smell the roses, you know, saying just really enjoy being there together.
Her, you know, insight on, you know, what it's like to be at Olympic Games kind of prepare us for what it's going to be like with media, security, the Olympic Village, the venue, the event, and how it is something way different than a world championships, which we do have a lot of experience in.
Experiencing the crazy fan support is what the UW alum now looks forward to.
I think that's the most exciting part about it. We love playing in an arena where it's loud and rowdy, and we know it's going to get a lot of coverage on NBC. So we're excited that our fans who couldn't come to Olympics will be able to watch us and cheer us on from afar. We definitely feel that support even when we're not around it.
Funny, we're hearing this story because NBC 15 is your official Olympic station.
Imagine that.
Yeah, the opening ceremonies are February 12th. I love it. I love
it. Nervous for her now. I'm starting to get nervous.
You do get excited, and they work so hard for so many years.
They do.
It's a big deal.
Cross your fingers.
Mm-hmm.